In this video, we go over Windows Virtual Desktop Spring Update 2020. Hello everyone, I'm Travis and this is Zeraldos. Microsoft recently announced the Windows Virtual Desktop Spring Update is in public preview. This is a significant change from the current Windows Virtual Desktop implementation. In this video, I go over all the goodness that's included with the Spring Update and walk through the new portal experience. Before that, please take a second to subscribe, and if you enjoy these videos, like, share, and click the bell icon to get notifications of new content. The biggest change, or at least the change that enables all the other changes, is that Windows Virtual Desktop is now a full-fledged Azure Resource Manager or ARM service. The current Windows Virtual Desktop experience is in its own database. It can interact with Azure services, but it's not in the same management plane as the other resources, such as compute and networking. Let's take a look at what changes with the Spring Update now that it's an ARM service. All objects are now part of a resource group with role-based access control available. One of the issues a lot of people faced with Windows Virtual Desktop was the lack of portal management and the need to use PowerShell to do most of the tasks. We could always deploy a host pool through the portal. Now, with Windows Virtual Desktop with Spring Update, we can manage from the Azure portal without the need to use PowerShell. Speaking of PowerShell, there's a new set of AZ Windows Virtual Desktop commands to manage Windows Virtual Desktop. This is part of the AZ PowerShell module and runs on PowerShell Core. How about the inability to use groups to grant access to virtual desktops and applications? How maddening was that? Well, I'm glad to tell you that remote apps and desktops can be assigned with Azure AD groups in the Spring Update. I wrote a script a while ago to sync the contents of a group to Windows Virtual Desktop. That's no longer needed with the Spring Update. This is a welcome change for sure. There is a dedicated process to scale out the number of VMs in the portal, and monitoring is enhanced with the ability to send data to log analytics, a storage account, or event hub. There's also an option to select the region to store service metadata. US regions are currently available with more to be added soon. Now that Windows Virtual Desktop uses ARM behind the scenes, there are other changes to be aware of. Remember the tenant group, tenant, host pool, session host hierarchy? That's now gone. With the Spring Update, the relationship between the objects is much flatter and each object is part of a resource group with a location. The first thing to notice is that there's no tenant group or tenant. Most deployments didn't use tenant group. If you did, you likely manage multiple environments, maybe as an MSP. That functionality is now available with Azure Lighthouse. The tenant was the top level of a Windows Virtual Desktop organization. That functionality is now in the workspace. A workspace is a logical grouping of applications. Each Windows Virtual Desktop application must be associated with a workspace. Like before, host pools can be personal or pooled. App groups can be either remote apps or remote desktop, each assigned to a user or group. Just like before, a host pool has a desktop application group automatically created and can have only one remote desktop application per host pool. And also like before, you can have many remote app groups per host pool. Unlike the current version of Windows Virtual Desktop, users can be assigned to both a remote desktop app group and a remote application group in the same host pool. A user, however, cannot log into the remote desktop and launch a remote app at the same time. Let's talk about how these fit together. A host pool contains session hosts. Nothing new there. You can create an empty host pool and add session hosts later, or create the session host when you deploy the host pool. Application groups are dependent on host pools. A host pool can be empty, but you would need to manually add the application. There can be one remote desktop application group and one or more remote app group. The remote app group can contain multiple applications. Application groups have to be registered with a workspace. Users interact with the workspace. Users can be granted access to the application group, but the application group still needs to be assigned to the workspace before it's available to the user. Enough of me talking, let's jump in and deploy an environment. In the following demo, we will register a resource provider, create a workspace, create a host pool and session host, create an application, and test the login process. Let's get started. Let's get started with the demo. The Spring Update is in public preview, so we have to register the resource provider first. Start by going to the Subscriptions and Resource Provider. Search for Desktop, select Microsoft.desktop virtualization, and click Register. You only need to do this once per subscription. Let's create an empty workspace next. This is what users will interact with and the applications will end up being part of. Go to All Services and search for Virtual. Click on Windows Virtual Desktop. You can see here it's in preview. Go to Workspaces and create new by clicking the Add button. I'm going to create a new resource group and add all the objects I'm creating during this demo to the same resource group. Keep in mind that objects don't need to be in the same resource group, but they do need to be in the same region to be accessible by one another. The exception is session host objects. Those can be in any location. I'll name it WVD Test RG. I'll give the workspace the name WVD Workspace and give it a friendly name and a description. The location will be set to Central US. You can select any region you want. This will be an empty workspace, so I'm going to leave the application group to know. And we'll review and create. The workspace is finished. Now if I go back to All Services, Windows Virtual Desktop, and go into My Workspaces, here it is. Next, let's create the host pool. We'll also create the session host. We'll go to Host Pool and click Add. I'm going to use the same resource group. I'll give it a name. Select my region. And notice that the metadata will be stored in that region. I'll set the type as pooled. I can set the max number of users per session host if I want. And I'll leave the load balancing to breadth first. I'll go to virtual machines. And we're going to add a virtual machine. This is similar to the current deployment process. I'll change the size. I'll use a B series for this. I'll set the number as 2. And I'll give the VM's name prefix. The image will be from the gallery. And I'll just select 1909 with Office Pro Plus. You can change the OS disk type. I'll set it to standard. That's a little cheaper. Notice it doesn't default to add a new VNet. Instead, it selects an existing one. That caused a lot of headaches for people because session hosts could not join the domain on a new VNet and the deployment would fail. Make sure the VNet you select has access to your domain controller. I'll set my subnet. I'll leave the next couple options as default. I do want to specify domain and OU. I'll add the domain join account. This is an account that has rights to add VMs to the domain. And enter the password for that account. Click Next to go to Workspace. I'm going to register the app group, and I'm going to select the workspace that we already created. Notice you have the option to create a new workspace. I'm going to go to Review and Create, and create the host pool and session hosts. We'll give this a few minutes to finish, and I'll be back once it's done. Okay, that finished. Next, let's look at the host pools. I'll come back to All Services, go to Windows Virtual Desktop, and Host Pools. Here's the host pool we just created. And notice if we go to Session Host, there's an option to add more. I won't do that, but that's where it's located. Also, if we look at the host pool properties, there's an RDP settings option. Here you can set the RDP options for users that connect to this host pool. This is only available with PowerShell in the existing Windows Virtual Desktop implementation. Next, let's go to Application Groups. Notice under Application Groups, it shows the Desktop Application Group. We're going to add a new application group. I'm going to select the existing resource group. Our host pool is set. We only have remote app because we already have one desktop application group assigned to this pool. And I'll give it a name. Next, we'll go to assignments, and I'm going to add an Azure AD group. Here we're going to select some applications. I'm just going to throw in a couple start menu applications. At least one session host has to be available in order to get at the start menu apps. We'll do paint. And I'll add another application. This time let's select WordPad. Next I'll go to the workspace. And I do want to register this to a workspace. Here tells me that another application group in the pool has been registered to this workspace. So it's going to register to the same workspace. I'm going to go to review and create. And create. That finished, I'm going to go back to Windows Virtual Desktop and preview. Application groups. And it could take a few seconds to show up, but there it is. So we've got my Windows app. Here you can see assignments. It's assigned to my WVD users group. Now if I go back to my desktop application group, this was created by default when I set up the host pool. If we go to assignments, nobody's assigned to this group. So I'm going to add the same user group. Let's go back. We'll go to workspaces. Here's my Windows Virtual Desktop workspace. And under application groups, here you can see the two application groups are available in the workspace. Let's test access next. I'm going to open an incognito window. And I like to use the web client for this. Notice this is a different URL. I'll leave it in the description below. This is rdweb.wvd.microsoft.com/arm/webclient. The URL for the current version of Windows Virtual Desktop won't work. There it is. There are the three applications. I can open up a desktop session. I'll log in, and there's the desktop. I'll sign out. Here I'm back at all resources, and this time I'm going to open up Paint. And there is Paint. So that's working just as expected. That's it for the demo. That was an overview of the new features of Windows Virtual Desktop Spring Update. I'll have more detailed content coming up. Please subscribe, like, and click the bell icon for new content. Thanks for watching.